Hey guys, thanks for joining Patents TV today. I'm David Jackson with the Patents Project. Today we're going to be making some PVC projects to help your students. Well, hey guys, so now we're going to make the eye gaze out of PVC. I've already pre-cut all the parts and I will provide a parts list, a cutting list, and cost. It's really inexpensive. I bought all of my parts from Menards, and like I said, pre-cut. So for the eye gaze, I have these cut at 12 inches for the top and bottom bars. The legs I have cut at 10 inches. The other part of the sides of the bar are 5 1/4, but you can adjust these to whatever you need. And the feet are 4 inches. And then we have elbows, so you'll need 6 elbows, 4 tees, and I used 4 caps. Then you have these two little pieces here. I think these are about 1.5 inches. And we'll show you where those go. You also need Velcro, need PVC cutters. This one's a little harder to do because you really have to squeeze pretty hard. This is more of a lever action. $10 versus $25, but it does make a big difference. If you're gonna be doing a lot of cutting, you should use a chop saw. PVC, I buy it in 10-foot sections and then cut it down. It's really inexpensive. It's a couple bucks for a 10-foot section. What you can do, start with the elbows. And I pay attention to this bump because you'll see later why. We'll put these together, try to keep that bump on the same side. And then you're going to take your 5 1/4 and assemble those. And a T here. It's going to start looking like this. I want to make it symmetrical. Go over here, put a T. The T's are here because this will help give you the legs that you need. So 5 1/4 here, 5 1/4 here. Put your elbow, watch your bump so it's still on the same side. Bump. Put your 12 inch in here. You may have to pull apart a little bit, squeeze it in. And we won't lock it down until the very end. So there is the frame. Here are your short connectors. Put those in the T. T. Your two elbows with the bump towards the back. And again, you can adjust these to whatever you need for your specific student. If you're doing this on a desk, or you might be doing it on the floor, you can make these legs longer or shorter. You can make these legs shorter or longer if you need to change that. Put a T at the bottom. This is where we're going to do the feet. And then put these out here. This will give you stability. I put the caps on there just for a finished look. You don't have to. If you need to weigh it down, you could put some sand inside these feet to keep it from wobbling. But in general, it works all right. Put the caps on there. That's pretty much the eye gaze. The last thing you'll need to do is put your Velcro on the corners, or you can put a whole Velcro strip across here. And after you do that, you can put your pictures on here for your eye gaze. And then you can have the student make their selection and you can just watch their eyes make the selections for you. So as you see, I had to hold this up a little higher so you can make these legs longer. If you have a student that's on the floor, you can rotate this and you can look down as the student's lying on the floor looking up at you to make their eye gaze selections. So you can do this for anything you might need. So here's the handheld eye gaze device that you can make out of PVC. So the top tube is 5.5 inches, the bottom two are 2 1/4, and that accounts for the half inch difference by using the T in the middle and the elbows. So you need 4 elbows, 1 T, and a cap at the end. Under a buck, you can make this thing. And then put your Velcro. I used Velcro dots, but you can use a Velcro strip, and then you can change out your pictures and have the student make selections. So here's another way to use eye gaze. You can make selections with this. It's just a T, a cap, and the lengths cut to suit your needs. All right, and finally, we are back to the iPad stand. I like this. You can adjust this lots of different ways for whatever iPad or tablet you might have. You can make these parts shorter or taller if you need to change the angle of your iPad. And you can make these shorter or longer depending on which way you want to orient it. So what you need, I've tried to make this a little easier. So these are 4-inch pieces. You need 5 of these. You need 2 3-inch pieces, 2 2.5-inch pieces, two T's, six elbows. And this is where it's important to think about this little nub, because when you put these together, you want those oriented the same way so it doesn't wobble on the table. So take your 4-inch, put them together like this. You're going to be forming this piece right here. It's a 4-inch. This is one side of it. Then take your T's, put those in. Oops, T right here. And these 3-inch ones, this is what will give you a different angle for this side of the stand. That's why these are shorter. But again, you can cut those to whatever length you need. Keeping the nubs down at the bottom. Another 4-inch. So I've used four of the 4 inches so far. There's the 2.5 inch short ones. And sometimes when you're cutting these, it might chip or might be off a little bit. That's okay. Doesn't have to be perfect. And now we're gonna make the top piece. Put those on. And then there you go, you can put your iPad on here. So you've got this way, this angle, so portrait. You can do portrait on this side, and you can do landscape on this side. Sorry for the emails. So you can do flip it around either way. Now once you're all done, what you want to do is press down real hard to lock everything together. So you just use your body weight and press down on it. And that'll lock all the pieces together. And it'll be nice and tight. Okay, thanks for joining us today on Patents TV. You can follow us on Twitter, Facebook, or at patentsproject.org. That's spelled P-A-T-I-N-S project.org.